Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound, burning in a hopeless dream. Hold me when you go to sleep. Of your love when you depart, keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Sometimes Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Safe and sound.
Mama! 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 And I love my mother.
Mama!
I love my mother.
For a mansion in the sky, I may not know the moment, I may not know the
Jesus, help my mother's. Lord have mercy. I did not want to do for my mother, but I want to save my mother. I want medication. I need doctor for my mother. I want comfort for my mother. I want wife for my mother. I gave her water and oxygen. How will I do? I did what she did. You do not love her. People can say, what do you want about me? I know I love you, Mama. Yes, I promise people to give you food. People say things, but they don't know. But Lord, we know I am a blessed child. When you see me, you see my brother, I mean. My mother used to have a smile, which is my mother, Lord have mercy. God bless you.
Thank you. Mama had two daughters, Mafra Lawrence, we all know as Dear Juliet, and Myra Alexis, Sister Mai. She later got married to her late husband, Daniel Mc.Farlan, and had five children. She was a hardworking lady who enjoyed cooking, baking, and sewing. Some of her best dishes were mapa crab and stew meat. She used to say, "One thing, I love my food, especially stewed meat." She enjoyed celebrating the La Marguerite Flower Festival and country western music. During banana harvest time, Antonia used to assist her husband by boxing the bananas. Mina and Daniel were farmers, and she enjoyed selling at the market. She worked with Dienrit Famco as a supervisor, which she enjoyed dearly. She used to say that she was able to read and write, and her column would all allow her to do the playlist. Mama later traveled to Cuba to have a surgery to remove cataract from her eyes. She eventually suffered blindness in one eye and partially blindness in the other. The children would ask, "Mama, can you see?" She would answer, "I can't see anything in this eye, but I can see a little in the other eye." There were two children, her great-grand, she really loved. Sherine, who is in England now, she always used to go and buy her little fries for her, and Winnie Sir always used to sing to her. That softened her heart. As Mama got older, her health started to decline. After her 89th birthday, she took a toll for the worst and got bedridden. She was admitted to the OKU hospital on October 31st, 2022 and passed away peacefully on November 6, 2022. Our heart mourns deeply for our beloved mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, godmother, and friend. May your soul rest in perfect peace, Mom. You will surely be missed. We love you till we meet again, Mama.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the celebration of the life of our loved ones, Antonia. We are now ready to begin. Family members, immediate family members, walk down by the coffin so Father can start.
Good morning, dear sisters and brothers.
Good morning, Father.
I invite each and every one of you, please stand as we are going to start our funeral mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Praise be to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bless the body of Antonia with the holy water that recalls her baptism of which St. Paul writes, "All of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into His death. By baptism into His death, we are buried together with Him, so that just as Christ raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with Him by likeness to His death, so shall we be united with Him by likeness to His resurrection."
Entrance hymn, "O Lord, who may enter?" The first hymn on your booklet.
Thank you.
and Father. It is of faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery your servant Antonia, who has gone to rest in peace of Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Sit. Readers, please come up. Our first reading is taken from the Book of Wisdom, chapter 4, verses 7 to 15. And this will be read by Rokisha.
The virtuous man, though he die before his time, will find rest. Length of days is not what makes age honorable, nor number of years the true measure of life. Understanding, this is a man's gray hair. Untarnished life, this is ripe old age. He has sought to please God, so God has loved him. As he was living among sinners, he has been taken up. He has been carried off so that evil may not warp his understanding or treachery his seduced soul. For the fascination of evil throws good things into the shade, and the whirlwind of desire corrupts a simple heart. Coming to perfection in so short a while, he achieved long life, his soul being pleasing to the Lord. He has taken him quickly from the wickedness around him. Yet people look on, uncomprehending. It does not enter their heads that grace and mercy await the chosen of the Lord, and protection his holy ones. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In response to this reading, we sing, "The Lord is my shepherd, he lives."
Money.
is taken from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 15, verses 20 to 28, and this will be proclaimed by Elsa Molloy.
Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Death came through one man, and in the same way the resurrection of the dead has come through one man. Just as all men die in Adam, so all men will be brought to life in Christ, but all of them in their proper order. Christ as the first fruits, and then after the coming of Christ, those who belong to him. After that will come the end when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father. For he must be king until he has put all his enemies under his feet, and the last of the enemies to be destroyed is death, for everything is to be put under his feet. Though when it is said that everything is subjected, this clearly cannot include the one who subjected everything to him. And when everything is subjected to him, then the Son himself will be subject in his turn to the one who subjected all things to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
Alle, alle, alle. Hallelujah. Alle, alle, alle. Hallelujah. Alle, alle, alle. Hallelujah.
I am the resurrection. I am the life, says the Lord. Anyone who believes in me shall never die.
Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you,
chapter 11, verses 17 to 21. On arriving at Bethany, Jesus found that Lazarus had been in the tomb for 4 days already. Bethany is only about 2 miles from Jerusalem, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to sympathize with them over their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus had come, she went to meet him. Mary remained sitting in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you." "Your brother," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know he will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever listens and believes in me will never die." "Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into this world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please sit for the homily.
Dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, in the name of St. Michael's Parish, and myself express our heartfelt condolences to all the family members, friends, and well-wishers of our sister Antonia. Today we have come here to celebrate the life of our sister Antonia. Family members, friends, everybody have come here to give the last respect and right to our sister Antonia at this time. At this time, we are reminded of few things in order to realize our own existence and its values here on this earth. The first thing to understand in our life, that we are called to be grateful to God for giving us the breath of life. As we are being grateful to God, God also raising the question to each and every one of us at the every funeral service, that we are called to remember and raise this question to each and every one of us: do we have fear of God in our life? God gave us the breath of life. And do we have fear of God in our life here on this earth? And so every one of us are reminded, if I and you realize and understand that I have or that you have fear of God, then we begin to recollect and think about ourselves, where am I standing? Am I able to see Jesus in my life? Am I able to see God in my life? Am I able to see Jesus and God in my family? And are we able to walk in the right path? This is what the first thing I want each and every one of you to understand at this time. And so, when you begin to understand the fear of God, the existence of God in our life and in our families, that is a starting point to understand that we all are becoming people of God. Chosen people, chosen generation, and that is what we are called to today. We are called to understand and take the message at this time, because when you look at our nation, shooting, killing, stealing, breaking the churches and the business places and the houses, all these things are taking place because we don't have fear of God. We don't see the existence of Jesus in our life and in our families. And that is what each funeral service we are reminded about ourselves, to recollect about ourselves, am I able to journey with Jesus on my existence here on this earth in order to celebrate our life, not after death, but why will we live? We are called to celebrate our life with Jesus. That is what our real existence, that is what the real presence of God in our life can be seen in our personal life and in each other and in our family life. That is what the first message that I want each and every one of you to take the message. And when you look at today's first reading and the second reading, it says to each and every one of us, death brings end to everything. When we live our life, we have pain, suffering, challenges. We have ambitions. We want to achieve. We want to accumulate. And we want to be better than the other persons. And so, in all of these things, death puts an end to our life and all the suffering and pain. And that is what today, second reading, clearly saying to each and every one of us. If death has put an end to all the suffering and pain of this world, it shows to each and every one of us that it greater life, joyful life after death, and that is what Jesus says to us in today's second reading. And so, in order to have the joyful, peaceful, happy life after our death, family get together or we come together in order to celebrate or the get together of the family of the deceased. Okay, this is what the point I want to say to each and every one of you. Sometimes we don't look at the person or talk to the person when they leave. We don't care for the person when they leave. And so, today the message that I want you to take, my dear sisters and brothers, all of us are called to care for each other in all the ways possible so that we are able to do the work of God and then able to become the people of the resurrection here on this earth. That is what today's gospel reading saying to each and every one of us and to Martha and Mary in today's gospel reading. I know that our brother will rise again, but Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. Do you believe this? And she says, yes, Lord, I believe. And this is what the belief that we need to have and see the people of the resurrection here on this earth, not after death. And so, today, all of us have come here to celebrate the life of our sister Antonia and pray for her soul. And so today, we are called to remember all good things and take to your life. Your granny, your mother, grandmother, friend, neighbor, all of us, if you are really loving her, there are a lot of good things. Her love, care, support, joyfulness, and this is what you are called to take. That comforts you, that consoles you, that strengthens you. That is what today I want you to take the message so that our sister life and her teachings may continue to live and bear fruit in your life and in your family. Having this in our minds, let us continue to pray that God will bless each and every one of us so that we are able to understand how we are able to see Jesus and how we are able to walk in the path of Jesus and how Jesus is able to bring the life in fullness so that we are able to celebrate our life in the life of Jesus. May Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Please stand for necessary prayers. Those who have prayers, please come forward. And after every prayer, we sing, Lord Jesus, hear our prayers.
Confidence, we ask him to save all his people living and dead.
Prayer for the church. Lord, we commend the leaders of your church to you. His Holiness Pope Francis, all bishops, especially Archbishop Gabriel Malaze, all priests, deacons, and all those who serve in various ministries of the church. We pray that your Holy Spirit bless and guide them in proclaiming your word in a Spirit bless and guide them in a manner that the lady will understand and draw closer to you. We pray to the Lord.
Family, as we grieve the loss of our beloved mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, sister, and aunt. We pray that the Holy Spirit comfort, console, strengthen, guard, and guide us during this difficult moment. Lord, bless and keep us as a united family with love and care for each other. We pray for the increased faith and trust in you so that we do not stray away from you. We pray to the Lord.
Prayer for the sick. Our Lord and God, we believe you when you said, I am the Lord that heals you. We pray for all the people who are sick in St. Lucia and all over the world. We pray that you be merciful to them and grant them your healing favor. We ask that your Holy Spirit lead and guide all those who care for them during their illness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Prayer for the deceased. Lord God, offer of life, we thank you for the life of our mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, sister, aunt, cousin, and friend. We thank you for the blessings you bestowed upon her during her life. As you have called her back to you, we pray that you'll be merciful unto her and grant her a place in your heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed sister. Cleanse her of her sinfulness and grant her the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
We will now have a collection to help with the cost of living with the church. During this time, we sing, We Stand for God.
We stand for God and for His glory, ever to pray and follow. Thank you.
Stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and evils may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be attentive, O Lord, to our prayers for your servant Antonia, whose funeral day we celebrate, that through the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, graciously grant care to the company of your saints, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying, as one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gabriel, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Antonia, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor receive us forever and ever. At the Savior's command and born by divine teaching, we dare to say,
please stand.
With your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
And during this time we sing, bind us together.
Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. That is why we sing.
Mygal, the Lamb of God. Mygal came who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. In the body of Christ, give us your mind.
Please sit. Those who will be receiving communion, please come up. And during this time, we sing, "Oh, what could my Jesus do more?" It's in the center page of your booklet. The communion.
Let us pray. Just as you have lovingly accepted, O Lord, our prayers and sacrificial offerings for the soul of your servant Antonia, so we humbly entreat you, if any stain of sin have clung to her, it may be wiped away by your merciful forgiveness through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please sit. We will now have the signing of the register. Vincent Mc.Farlan, Elsa Molwe, Shavima Lawrence, Myra Alexis, please go to the table where the young man is going. During this time, we sing, I'm Thinking of a Little Lady.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Antonia, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Antonia again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow,
The mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of His kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
During this time, we sing Blessed Assurance.
Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fullness of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. In His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior. Perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. My story, this is my song,
soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take you to Himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Antonia in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with Him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Antonia in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you
and with our sister forever. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Antonia, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sin she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead it into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is born no longer, may you find eternal rest. Whoever believes in me, even though that person die, shall live. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes and lives in me shall never die. And so, my dear sisters and brothers, in peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Amen. Our recessional hymn, I'll see thee, mother dear.
My dear sisters and brothers, our sister Antonia has gone to rest in peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be united one day with our sister. Together may we meet Christ Jesus, when he who is our life appears in glory. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you call out the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister may sleep in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light we see light and know the splendor of God. For you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound, burning in a hopeless dream, hold me when you go to sleep. Keep me in the warmth of your love when you depart. Keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound, burning in a hopeless dream, hold me when you go to sleep, keep me in the warmth of your love when you depart, keep me safe, safe and sound. Safe and sound. Drown. strength of your arms. Keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down. Keep me safe, safe and sound.
I need to be a job, not a well. Now, what you die? Now, I'm going to be my wife. I can't have it. I want to give it to you. How quick will we? No, because I'm going to be a lot. How fast will we? No, I'm going to be a lot. I'm going to be a lot. Too late, too. Too late, too. I'm going to be a lot. Too late, too. Open my room, no.
Lift me up. Hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Burning in a hopeless dream, hold me when you go to sleep, keep me in the warmth of your love when you depart. Keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Burning in a hopeless dream, hold me when you go to sleep. Keep me in the warmth of your love when you depart. Keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Drowning in an endless sea, take some time and stay with. Strength of your arms, keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Burning in a hopeless dream, hold me when you go to sleep. Keep me in the warmth of your love when you depart. Keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Drowning in an endless sea, take some time and stay with me. Keep me in the strength of your arms. Keep me safe, safe and sound.
Help me, 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 help me,
lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound, burning in a hopeless dream. Hold me when you go to sleep, keep me in the warmth of your love when you depart, keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound. Drowning in an endless sea, take some time and stay with me. Strength of your arms, keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down, keep me safe, safe and sound. Lift me up, hold me down.
Right down. How are you? Everything good? Yeah. Wonderful. Everybody all right?
Yeah. Good.
Oui,
Bastille est pour nous faire une conclusion.
Vamos a ver, Tout. Avec toi, Excuse me. Okay, viewers, the family would like to say a big thank you to everyone who reached out in whatever way possible during these trying times. The family appreciates your support. To all those who called, all those who sent in well wishes, the family is grateful. And also to our online viewers, thank you very much. Hope you guys have a blessed and amazing afternoon. One love to the max.
Yes,
put someone place the wreath on top, please.
Okay.
Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close.